One out of every seven species has been identified as threatened or endangered. That's just way too many. So we've got to reduce our footprint somehow. And so what we got to do is figure out how to do that, utilizing the best technology that we can.
This project is truly an international collaboration that involves the most advanced data sets that are available out there.
So the basis of the project is to use NASA remote sensing technologies to help us to build models of biodiversity around the planet. We are using NASA space-based technologies from the International Space Station, three sensors in particular, the JEDI, EcoStress, and DSIS sensors, to peer down and map the habitat. We tie it to acoustic remote sensing so that we can develop a catalog of all the animals that are present at a location. We're ground truthing using UAV-based flights, where we're looking at and constructing the vegetation at extremely high resolutions. So what we're doing in all four of our locations is calibrating the sensors on the International Space Station for NASA.
And those locations, we're going to have very detailed information about, you know, from the ground. And for those locations where we don't have it, you know, the key idea here is developing a model so that you can predict forest structure and also, you know, other, you know, biodiversity related information from NASA satellite only without collecting ground data.
The study locations are selected on the basis of just trying to understand the diversity of forest ecosystems and how they relate to animal biodiversity. One site is our backyard here at Purdue. We call it our sandbox. It's a site of a Tippecanoe soundscape study that's been ongoing since 2007. So we tie it to long-term acoustic surveys that we've been doing here. We have three other sites that are just really cool to talk about. One is the Miyombo Woodlands in Tanzania. This is a location where you've just got cool primates. The soundscape is really quite incredible.
We collect audio data of the forest every hour of every day, generating terabytes of recordings. Here's a visualization for one location over an entire year. The colors represent the different animal sounds of this forest, and we can use this visualization to understand how biodiversity changes over time.
A second study site is Mongolia, mostly dominated by grasslands, but the forests are a really important part of indigenous community use of natural resources. Our final location is the mangrove ecosystems of Bangladesh and a UNESCO World Heritage Site called the Sundarbans. It is the most pristine of the mangrove ecosystems in the world. And as you can imagine, not only are there like thousands of sounds at each location, but all of these sounds are really complex and they tell us a story about really what lives there.
I think the ultimate goal for this project is to get a better understanding of how we can better conserve the forest and its related plant diversity so that we can protect not only the plants within this forest, but also the animal or fauna species as well.